Welcome back to 101 Tutorials, Tips and Tricks with Natalia. And today in our video we are going to do some tutorial about big canvases, how to work. And I do have already a tutorial how to work with huge canvases. For example, as we saw before, this gorgeous canvas by Anne Marie Boone. Big gorgeous canvas. So in today's canvas will be a little bit different size, and that's the canvas that we worked last time in our video. We get enough together and I show you a few another tips. So that's the canvas we will work today on, and I find for myself a few different tricks that work better. I know I have a video, I explain how I work and also how to work by the color. So if you are like me, who like to work by the color, not by the section, and that's the canvas that we are gonna work on it. Big canvas, and I don't know if you can tell, but there's some diamonds already up there, especially on this side of the canvas I already placed. Two colors. So I want to show you how you can work on a big canvases by the color. Can we see the sparkles a little bit on the other side? Maybe not, but we can see this maybe more close to the table. And I will show you how you can work on such a long canvas. If you have such a little space in your house, maybe you have only your computer desk, you don't have a table of dining table that you can set up all your diamond painting and work all day long this out, put the stuff together, because somebody else have to use maybe the table for dinner or lunch. So I will give you a few tricks that actually work better for me that I was working before on my canvas, because the way I worked before, I would peel canvas a little bit from each corner, from side, from the top, from the bottom, and meet up on the center, and I would be done. For example, the canvas that is multi colored, so very like not patchy as this one, as we can see there's here like a big chunks of the same colors, instead of being in here very pixelated area on a canvas of Dreams of Elysium. So there's a different little bit techniques how you can work with them. So I find for myself better way. I don't say that this is gonna be a work for you, and I hope it is. So please let me in the comments down if this is gonna be work for you or not. But I find that this is better way than I was work before. It works for me, make me more comfortable to work on a longer canvas. And I will show you the tips that I created for myself to work with this long canvas. And I hope this will work for you as well. So before we start our tutorial, I would love to welcome all our new subscribers, all viewers who join our channel and all social media. So if you still do not subscribe to our YouTube channel, please do so, hit the notification bell, and you will always know when new video will come up, because between me and Anna, we post every week. So you will have something, find something new, something old, something interesting, something very incredible. So please join our channel and let's go start our tutorial, and I will show you all my tips that I created for myself. Okay, so let's get start our tutorial. The canvas are so big that I can't kind of fit in a frame together with the canvas. So if my head chop, ignore that. So here's what we have. We have this huge big canvas, and let me face this to you. And it's right now I'm on a dining table, and as you can tell, dining room, dining table, it's fit almost, taking all my space on a table. So usually when I was working before on a big square canvases, for example like 60 by 80, I would do peel a little bit at a time from this side. I would do from this side. Of course, one side would be kind of like a rolled on this side, right? And then I would go all the way around, peeking through the each side, and create my diamond painting all the way around, because I like to work by the color. So I would pick color that it stand out to me, and I would go through the whole canvas. But with such a long canvas, it doesn't really work as was working on a square that is kind of shorter, so it was easier to maneuver around. So what I did, because we have here clear sheet, and this is plus, because I always like to see where each color would be on a canvas, so this has worked perfect for me. And it has quite a bit excess of the clear sheet on each side. So what I did, you can measure, put your canvas, if you have this particular canvas, on half, find your center, and what you need to do, peel your, well, you don't need to do, this is what I did, sorry. This is what I did, this is what worked for me. I peel this side of the canvas all the way to the center. For example, I'm gonna stop in here, but because I already did, so I peel and then I cut my clear sheet right where I want it to cut, all the way across, right? So now I have two pieces of clear sheet that cover my diamond painting, right? So if I show you from here, now you can see I can open from here and I can open from here. So how I work in here, and I already done in here two darkest color. It's 310 and 939, which is dark blue and black. So it's really, really comfortable, because now after I did this, I literally can work on as little space as this diamond painting, okay? This is how much space I need right now. So what I do, I pull, okay, if I work on my desk at the computer, so you, of course, you have the keyboard that pull out in here, or even you can put this, if you sit comfortable in here right now in a chair, you can put this side of the canvas on your lap. You peel from this side of your canvas, from one side of the corner, right? And we will see this more close into the camera when we go to my desk. I just want to right now, because I want to show you a little bit in a better view, because the table desk really small. So here is a little bit more comfortable. So I place my diamonds in here. My hands is resting on my clear sheet, and I place. I peel my sheet as far as I go. And don't worry to expose a little bit of this glue to the air while you're working in here. If you're really, really afraid, you can put parchment paper on the top and you're gonna be okay. Now I can see that I didn't push one of the bead and it's shining into my face. Okay, it's pushed now. All right, so I peel as much as far as go, and what's good about this canvas, it's a patches of the colors, it's not pixelated at all. So if you don't like pixelated confetti, we call diamond painting, this is probably would be just awesome for you who don't like to have so many color changes. So I do, for example, I cut my canvas up there, the clear sheet, in half. So I kind of go like 50% from this corner, right, to my canvas. I close this side. Now I flip this side around to me, and I peel from the center this way canvas now. Okay, now I peel my clear sheet from here. This one side go on my lap with those diamonds that we place, and now I start from the center of the canvas towards me. So basically what I do now, I kind of separated canvas on four pieces, if you think of. So what we do, we cut clear sheet on half, we work from this side to another fourth. So let's say you have now four, instead of one big canvas, pretend you have a four, because here is the half, and we're gonna separate this half and another half. So we work from this side to this half, and then from center of the canvas to this half. And then we move to another side. Now we peel from this half to here, finish your diamonds colors, and then you peel from this side only this way. So it feels like you always work on a little canvas, not very big one. And it's so comfortable when you like to place your diamonds by the colors through the whole canvas. I'm telling you, these techniques are so awesome. And plus, when you finish this diamond painting, you're not gonna need this clear sheet anyway. But I always save them. Why I save them? If I don't have a frame in this particular moment to frame my canvas, I would, now because I have two of those sheets, I can save for something that was made of those non-see-through paper, when usually it's go on a double sticky tape. But I would do my roll my canvas. If you finish your diamond painting and if you want to roll it to save and store for later, always make sure to roll with diamonds up. The more tight you roll, it's gonna be just perfect. But if you roll your canvas the other way, okay, I'm gonna finish my thing, what I'm gonna say. After you roll your canvas all the way, then you use your clear sheet to roll it again with, to cover up all the diamonds, and you can just put some kind of elastic to keep it, and you can store that way till you find a usable frame to do diamond painting to decorate your wall in the house. But now what I say, if you roll your canvas with diamonds, especially square drills, because square drills sits more tight on your canvas than would be round drills. So if you roll very, very tight, it's go nicely right now tight because there's no diamonds on it, and it's kind of like a listening to roll this way. But if you roll your diamonds already finished this way, you kind of squishing those diamonds together to each other, and they will pop each other. So always make sure when you finish your diamond painting and you want to store it, roll diamonds up, not down. So these techniques, I think it's really good about how I separated this canvas now for four and four little kind of pieces to work for me. And I finished my two first colors so fast. Now I even was teasing you on a Facebook group that I would raise somebody, because to the time you work on the colors in the patches or little squares, I would run through the whole canvas with the same color in no time. And especially this will be another good tip for you if you like to work with multi-placer, because the way we work, and we should go and do this close to the camera on my desk maybe, because the way you work this way, right, you're not gonna place your diamonds horizontally through your canvas. It's kind of more comfortable to work this way, short way link, so your diamonds will be placed more straight. And let me show you a little bit more close shot to the canvas, and we will work together and pick another color we're gonna work on it, and we will start a little bit work progress together and talk and give you some another tips on the way. Okay, before we start our drill together, I just want to show you the part that I already finished, all those dark diamonds. And in here, a dining table with the light is really kind of, you can see all the shading. So two colors in here, black and dark blue, 939, I believe it's a DMC code for blues. So this is how I start working. I pick my most darker color first, which is black. And usually to create video with you, I like to go with the bright color, not something dark that it's hard to see. And in this, I was working at night as well, so I was using a light pad, as black and blue diamonds was kind of hard to separate them in a bed lighting at night. But you can tell how already those trees create a shadow. So what next color I would do, if I would do by myself, I done already black, I done that dark blue. The next color what I would do, it's the symbol in here, there is a next darker shade, and I would go from darker to lightest, and I would create that. So this one is, let's check, where is it, let's find, well here, 823, it's another dark blue color. So I did this so quickly, and those lines look actually, okay, the other way, not bad. The drills looks wonderful, line up nicely together, you can see better on a blue color. And I went through the whole canvas. You can see where diamonds was placed. It's shining, but there's a little bit more patching here of blacks. There's mostly on this side of the canvas, it's a bright colors. And even if you're afraid of those confetti, you can see this same red trees, but it's so much calm down with no confetti, lots of the same patches of colors. So this one is really, really easy, kind of like cartoonish, I would say, scan of the scenery of this house. And it's just much easy to work for somebody who don't like very complicated canvases, but definitely nice and bright on a color. So with you, we're gonna pick something actually bright for today. For myself, I would work with another dark blue, but with you, we're gonna pick something nice and happy color. There's lots in one spot, so I was thinking maybe something in here to see those beautiful pinks or green. Usually greens are gorgeous. Of course, as always, I promise to start my video to shake this tray and make those lines look beautiful, because no matter how many times I do video steps, there's somebody always gonna ask. So I'm just gonna do it again. I put my tray funnel into my hand, I grab with my two fingers like this, I spread them first back and forth to get them all over the tray, and then I shake and crank my tray from left to right by shaking it nice and gentle. Doesn't have to be very strong to get those diamonds, catch all those lines. And when lines most likely visible, the excess of diamonds will stuck in here and go into the bottom of the tray. Then I grab to my other hand, just make sure my diamonds don't escape. I tap it slightly and shake it, let them fall into the bottom of my tray. And I have so much space to work in here now. Lots of beautiful diamonds. And these diamonds are gorgeous. It's a 904 DMC code. And I picked this green color because it's lots in here in this particular part of this diamond painting. So let me zoom as close as we can. I think this would be great. Now my canvas, the other side, I roll and put on my keyboard table. So only it's like a fourth of the canvas right now on a table, and that's exactly what I need right now. So the symbol we're gonna work on, well, let's do from beginning actually of the canvas, as I have already in here. So we're gonna start from the little little patches. And very often this symbol, okay, we need a light, could be interfere with the symbol of this more brighter color. Looks like a half of the circle. This canvas printed are so beautiful that I don't think you could have trouble to actually place your diamonds. It's really, really visible difference on the symbols. But also look for the back around. It is similar back around, but because those half circle kind of look bigger, so it's visible to separate them. I don't know, maybe different canvas look different, but so far I don't have any problems with it. It looks beautiful. Now, the way I place diamonds right now, I'm not gonna, okay, so this is how our diamond painting tall, this way and white this way, right? I will place each row of my diamonds, which is look like horizontal to you, but this is vertical from the top of the canvas to the bottom. Or obviously if I'm right-handed, so for me it's more comfortable to place from the left to the right, which is a mirror image to you, because this way I can see what I'm placing and not covering with my hand. If I would place, for example, first drill to the right side and then to the left, I can't speak today. So my bead, this bead, would be kind of a little bit on my way because I right-handed. So I kind of have to go around the bead. So for me, from left to right, it's much more comfortable, and that's the way I work. And also, if I put my bead, okay, we need to find a bigger area for that. Let me move canvas a little bit where we have more of these symbols, and that's the right in here. So this way it's gonna be more visual, better for you what I'm talking about. Okay, we have a wonderful patch of this color in here. So if I will go, for example, I would just grab this line and I will go here like horizontal through the whole canvas, and I step later back and look my line, how they will line up all the way to the top, each color, it will be dancing lines. They will not be straight, because you kind of it's better when you put your drill on the top and then you go down each row, because for me I can see this line of the square that facing me, and I can place them really nice and close to each other. Not sure if I'm doing a good job right now because the canvas kind of a little bit far away from me. I might have to move close to the camera. But I don't have to worry what's behind that bead up there. All I see is line in here in front of me. And if I create this line straight, it's mean my next line, well, when I place my bead and it doesn't have a room a little bit, it's mean the other bead placed a little bit not straight, and I have to kind of push it over a little bit. So my drill that I put right now fit properly on my line and push the other one bead away if it's not on a proper place. So that way I created all these colors in here, and I like the way they look. I literally don't think I need to even use a straightener in here. Of course, if you're gonna use your multi-placer, that's even more better tip, to use multi-placer vertical. So let's try, and we're gonna try from the top to the bottom, and I already see that this drill didn't stick to my multi-placer very flat, so I have to fix it. Let me maybe just fix the wax a little bit. Sometimes when you kind of when you smooth it out, wax with your finger and go in the right places. If not that case, then you just replace a new wax. And again, see, when I put my drills, the last drill a little bit sticking out, not sure if that's visible for you. Let me try to fix them. For example, as I did before in my tutorials, when I push on my drill and not to let them separate, I push them to the side, to one of the side, to make them line up straight and also get those drills together better. So let's see now if our line is better or not. We put next to it and looking on the last bead and walk. Let's do it again. Over and walk. So I think right now, as you can tell, the drills line up a little bit better, but the problems with the multi-placer always will be that there's some part will be missing. So that's why this handy dandy tool of straightener you can use after each line if you wish. It will take a time, but if you're not in a marathon, then I think it will be okay. Place here one line and then straighten up. Let's try to do another line by one at a time. And now I'm just gonna look the way I place, and if I have to, my drill will push the other one that doesn't feel to me like it's straight. Because this jams, this drills, are really equal size, so that's why it's easy. I can't guarantee that this is gonna work for you with any other brand or company, because they all have a different kind of drills, and sometimes they are different sizes. Some of them could be 2.5 millimeters, some of them could be 2.8 millimeter. And they could be taller, could be more flat. So it's, you know, depends on the drills, how you can place them. So now I put my other line and I will straighten this one. Even it's already look perfect to me. I don't know from camera, from the top, how that look like. So this is one of the tips that I think if you create this whole canvas in directions from the top of your canvas, and I can zoom out a little bit more so you can see better. Okay, so I will work on this green color all the way from beginning of my canvas to the halfway, and then I will flip. Okay, we can go back forward a little bit, and now because I have in here on my table not much space, so I'm just, this one is rolling, and I don't have to pin in here because I roll and unroll all the time as I go. So now this one I'm just put like towards my camera, unroll to my half where I start my canvas, where is cut piece, where is it, it's thick nicely. Okay, right in here. Because when you cut, you have to a little bit overlap to cover the glue, because the clear sheet as are really long on each side of the canvas, so there's no problem the other way to have a little bit overlap them together like this to hide all the glue so nothing else stick. So now I'm gonna start from this side. Okay, open as much as I need, bring you close to me, and now we can start on the other side. So same thing, the top of the canvas right now is, this is top of the canvas and this is the bottom of the canvas. But for me, the way I look right now, I'm still right-handed, so this is gonna be my top point and I go this way. So always vertical. Well, I'm showing you because you are horizontal to me right now, and my apology. So if I can zoom out back and just to show you canvas as I should show you the way it's face you, okay? All my drills that I will place, it will be go lines in here. If I use multiplacer, I still will use multiplacer from top to the from top canvas down, not horizontal. Horizontal lines with multiplacer will create wiggle line later on the end when you look your diamond painting straight to you. These lines will not straight because multiplacer will place them a little bit off. It looks like you place in a straight one line, but then when you go the other line, it will interfere your first bead by placing a, for example, this squishy. It will a little bit off line, and then they will be creating kind of wiggles. So I suggest that you place this way because that's how visual your eyes will look on a canvas when you're looking at from floor on the wall where your picture is in on it. So always go this way and you will finish your diamond painting in a very fast way and beautiful way. And if you use this technique as I do, please let me know if you like this way or not, because I think it is very, very comfortable to work this way on a little spaces with very minimum table space. You can roll and your canvas kind of separated on four chunks and you just work on it. And yes, those diamonds are beautiful already, and I cannot wait to finish this one. I still have an awesome canvas for you to unbox one day. I still have some surprises. So yes, I'm gonna start drill a little bit by myself, and I will be working on a blue color and show you progress in my next video. As you can see, this steps is really, and this techniques work for me very well. So I hope you can incorporate them into your style of work. If you work on a very, very big canvas, it's possible you will find that this way, this little bit of trick will give you so much, kind of save your workspace and make at the same time work very comfortable on a huge, huge canvases. So if you don't have yet big canvas, go ahead and purchase one before it will run out. And I've received so many questions about, for example, when I finished my Dreams of Elysium, and many of you wanted to purchase, and you say that so many canvases that you wanted, it's already sold out. And we are apologize for that, but we hope that in the summertime, our store at dreamers.com will be restocked with new canvases, and I heard with new artists. So keep your eye open and put something into your favorite if you like. Put in a wish list so you can find later very quickly in your shopping cart when it's ready to kind of reopen our store with new stuff in the store. So thank you so much for watching this video. It was my pleasure as always to work with you. Please hit subscribe button, give me thumbs up if you like this video, and I will see you in my next episode.